Greetings and welcome to Chapter 4 of the AESDirect video webinar series. In this section, we're going to cover Step 3, the Commodities section. And this is where you're going to enter all of the required information about the commodities that you're exporting. So first, you'll notice the two tabs here at the top of the screen, Line Summary and Line Details. Anytime you wish to review all of the commodity information that you've entered, especially if you have multiple commodity lines, you would select the Line Summary screen. In order to provide the details about your commodities that you're exporting, you would select Line Details. And to start, the first mandatory field is the Export Information Code. So if we click in the field box, we'll notice the first code is OS for all other exports. This is used for the vast majority of exports, unless you have a particular government license that you are shipping with. Our next required field is the Schedule B or HTS code. And this is a 10-digit classification code. Our next field, we're asked to describe the commodity. Then we'll have to provide a quantity. And in this case, it's asking me for the number of used vehicles that I'm exporting. So I select one. But please note that the first unit of measure field can change depending upon the classification number that you enter. Next field is the origin of goods field, and you'll have the option of selecting domestic or foreign. Then you will be asked to enter the value of your goods. And the shipping weight in whole kilograms. Our next field is the export control classification number, but this is only required if you're exporting with a certain government license type. In this case, we are not, so we leave it blank. We are then asked to enter a license type code or a license exemption code. So by clicking in the field box, you can see the list of options available to you. If you have a government license, you would select the appropriate license from below. But in this case, this is an unlicensed shipment, so we select C33 for no license required. The next question is, does this filing require participating government agency data? It does not, so we select no. And now, since we're exporting a used vehicle, we are asked to enter some specific information from the vehicle's title. Once you enter the vehicle's title information, please be sure to click the Save button. And the system then stores your vehicle information. So now that I've entered all the information for my first commodity, I do have one more commodity to export. So I select this green button that says Add New Line. And again, I'm asked to select an export information code. This is where I'll select OS for all other exports. I will then provide a Schedule B or classification number. Provide my commodity description. And in this case, I'm not required to provide a quantity or a weight, as the first unit of measure is X'd out. The origin of goods are domestic. The value of the goods. And then again, since I'm not exporting with a government license, I do not need to provide an export control classification number. And then my license type code that I select is C33 for no license required. And this filing does not require participating government agency data. And then when I get to the bottom of the screen, I can save my line by selecting this blue button here. And now to ensure that all of that information was captured correctly, or if I just wish to review it, I click on Line Summary at the top of the screen. And now you'll see that all the information that I entered is summarized here by column. So that concludes Chapter 4. Please advance to Chapter 5, where we'll cover the transportation section.